Hey guys, Ace Networker, and I want to welcome you to this subnetting course. And I just want to give you a little bit of rundown of what you're going to get in this short video. When I first got into IT and I got into computer networking, I realized that there's not a lot of mathematics involved, but until you get into things like subnetting and understanding subnets and why we need subnets and laying network cables out, you need to be able to measure those correctly, because if you don't, you could run short and that could cost you a lot of money. I know that from personal experience. Anyway, subnetting is the process of, and we're just going to generalize it here, it's the process of dividing a larger network, your network or the network that you're an administrator on or that you're hired to administrate or to set up or design or whatever it happens to be, to troubleshoot. Your network, it may be a large network, so to cut down on the broadcast traffic and to cut down on the large amounts of collisions that might occur or bottlenecks in traffic where there's a lot of traffic flowing down one or more connections or through one or more devices, that's kind of just like highway traffic, it's kind of bottlenecking and it's kind of building up. You want to be able to cut that down. So that what you do with subnetting is basically you're creating a sub network or multiple sub networks on out of your larger network. The word subnet is short for sub-network. This essentially means a smaller network within a larger network. Subnetting is the method of breaking down a large network into smaller networks or subnets, and there are multiple reasons for doing this. Subnetting is done to make your network really more manageable and more efficient. Let's say, for example, that you have a company with 6,000 employees. Your ISP assigns you a Class B IP address with a default subnet mask. A Class B IP address will allow approximately 65,000 usable IP addresses for all computers or devices on your network. Now, you could put all of your employees in one large network. In fact, if you have a small business, this would be just fine, putting them all in one large network. But if you have a fairly large business or medium to large business with, for example, 6,000 computers or devices, then this could present a very serious problem because of traffic issues that are caused by so many broadcasts and traffic on the entire network and bottlenecks that might be created over a single connection, over a single device, that type of thing. You also want to create more security on your network by not allowing somebody from, say, the sales department or research and development to access the HR department and that type of thing. So subnets have multiple solutions within them whenever you create them. If a problem occurs on your network and you don't have it divided into subnets, it's just one large network, it's extremely difficult to actually pinpoint where it may be in a large network. Where is the issue? Where is the traffic issue? Where is the connectivity issue? That type of thing. In yet another example, what if your business is spread out or operates in, say, three different geographic locations or more? This would also be a problem if everybody was in the same subnet or on the same network subnet. So the best or better way is to break it down your network into smaller networks or subnets. Essentially, subnetting is done by changing the default subnet mask by what we call borrowing some of the bits in the IP address that would be used for hosts on one large network and using them to create defined subnetworks. Now, I get into much more detail on how and why this is done in my simple subnetting course, and you can get access to it by signing up on my email list and also getting access to it along with the two free Network Plus test question websites. And I'm also going to be giving you a kind of a rundown on what the Network Plus test covers. And in other words, what categories you need to study for the Network Plus test. So you might want to sign up for that and get access to it as soon as possible. But there's more detail in the simple subnetting course, and I'm going to provide that for you in that. I wanted to take a minute to show some of the why and how on the concept of subnetting on this short video.